50 left.
So some interesting action.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Who's next?
Hurry!
That's our winner! Here we go!
Yeah, what you got to think about on the ground is being smooth. Pace is nothing if you can't hit 10 in a row in, okay? If you hit it as hard as you want and they don't go in, you're not winning much, okay? So let's work on the pace, developing the stroke. Can you...
and lemon tea.
Your head now, baby.
job, Nick. Tough competition, huh?
Yeah.
Did you have fun out there?
Yeah.
Let me recover each time. Okay. I want you to think about good preparation, good early racket preparation. Getting back to the center each time. Let me get back to the center. Short ball. Four forehand volleys. And then four backhand volleys. They may need more time than this, Emily. Okay. Okay. Then we stop, bring you back, and you alternate forehands and backhands. Then you alternate volleys. Okay, so we had a little bit of movement. Simple, huh? Okay, Alex. Same way. Four forehands to start, getting back to the center each time. Nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. That's it. And recover. That's perfect. Perfect. Stepping forward. Good. Your granddad will like that when he sees that. Okay, four backhands now. That's it. Get those shoulders turned. Let's see that contact point a little bit earlier. Okay, now short ball and attack. Forehand volleys. That's it. Four of them. Four backhand volleys. Keep that racket head up on the backhand volley and reach for it. Okay, good. Now let's pull you back. We'll alternate forehands and backhands. Think about the contact point on your backhand. Instead of being here, you're making contact here and you're playing it okay, but you're not getting as much pace as if you play it out there, okay? Here we go. Same way though. You don't have to swing as hard, just where you meet it. Yes. There we go. Good depth. Good depth too. Go to it. Okay. Early. That's good. Okay, two more. Okay. Really early, really early. There we go. Great hit. Okay, last one and then the approach. Yes, look at that. Good depth. Alternating volleys now. Okay, four overheads. Very good on the volley. Okay, back quickly. Keep the ball in front of you. Getting behind you just a little bit. I'll tell you what, you ought to look at the video from you last year, and then when you see this one, you get an idea of how much difference it makes when you bend that arm and how much more pace you have now on the overhead. Here we go, four serves. Here we go. Okay, keep that left foot still though. You stepped into the court. Keep it still. All right. Okay, that's good spin. You're tossing the ball just a little bit behind your head here. Okay, so that's what's enabling you to get all that spin. If you wanted to get a little bit more pace, you could toss the ball out a little bit further into the court and be able to have your body moving forward. Okay, you do that?
Yeah, sure.
That looks great.
Thanks.
Looks great. You're getting to the point where you're going to want to think about doing a little bit of a grip change on the volley.
What do you mean?
Well, you're right now playing the volley with the same grip you play the groundies with. Okay?
No, I play my backhand.
What's that?
I play my backhand with
No, I'm saying they're different grips,
yeah.
But the volley matches the ground stroke grip, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you're getting bigger, big enough to want to get into that continental grip, because things are going to start, as you start to get better and better, things are going to happen quicker for you at the net. So you're going to want to get into that grip
like that.
That lets you even a little bit more.
Even a little bit more than that?
No, just the other way,
right.
Yeah. But wrap your thumb around it, wrap your thumb around it.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can play forehand and backhand with the same grip. That's what you're going to have to do, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you want to think about that now. Okay? Thank you.